my friends, and welcome into another edition of the JayMac podcast. Today, answering a very important question: is there alien life on Earth or circling the Earth? Well, I've always believed that insects are the aliens of the Earth. They look like them. They look like how I would picture them. That's just my take. But as you know, the Pentagon has been conducting a UFO investigation. They have been releasing information, and they have promised reports on the information. We now have one of those reports out. This is from go.com by Luis Martinez, and I don't think you're going to like the answer. The Pentagon said that they have, there's a typo there. You gotta check your, and I'm totally guilty of this, so I can't complain, but I don't believe that that's a correct sentence. The Pentagon said that they has not yet been able to find any evidence that extraterrestrials may be responsible for the hundreds of UFO incidents they are reviewing, or that any alien beings may have crashed on Earth. Sorry to share the sad news with you. Senior Pentagon officials relayed this to reporters Friday in a briefing to highlight the broad review headed by the new All Domain Anomaly Resolution Office. You know, there needs to be a service just for acronyms, because this is ARO, A-A-R-O, the All Domain Anomaly Resolution Office. That's just awful. It's just awful. They have been working with other federal agencies to review unidentified aerial phenomenon, unidentified anomalous phenomena, or UAPs. That's the new term we use. We don't use UFOs anymore. We use UAPs, and has itself gone, let's see, we'll skip that. UFO enthusiasts have been waiting since October 31st for a long-delayed first annual update by the Director of National Intelligence to their 2020 report that could explain only one of the 144 incidents it reviewed. So, unfortunately, my friends, that is the bad news. One individual saying, I have not seen anything in those holdings to date that would suggest that there has been an alien visitation and alien crash or anything like that. He explained that by holdings, he was referring to documents, witness interviews, or written collections from witnesses. He said, I think it would be safe to say that there will be probably a number of these activities that can be characterized as non-adversarial systems, things like balloons and things like UAVs that are operated for purposes other than surveillance or intelligence collection. I did see a report that said there's been a lot more sightings of UAVs or UAPs of late. I'm going to guess that's because of the drone technology or UAV technology that everybody has access to. It could be like the Brady Bunch-ish episode. You guys remember the Brady Bunch episode where the boys set up an elaborate hoax in the backyard with some sheets and like a kazoo, and they convinced their sisters that they were being visited by aliens? Hey, I wouldn't rule that out as well. The story goes on to say, I would just emphasize there's not a single answer for all of this. There's going to be lots of different answers, he said, and part of my job is to sort out all of those hundreds of cases on which ones go to which things. So that, again, is from go.com. And I know many of you are saying, oh, come on. That's just the government hiding the real story, and that we're working with aliens, and that's where we're getting all of this new tech and all of those things. For me, myself, friends, I just don't believe it. I just do not believe in UAPs. I think that all of these, if you could really do a deep dive and have different angles on them, I think that they would all have some description, like the Bubble Boy. Remember the Bubble Boy and their UFO that they built and they send up in the air and said that they think their son was in the bubble and he was actually in the attic? I guess a Bubble Boy is not really the right term. And we were watching the news. I was reporting on it live, and we couldn't believe that maybe there was a kid in there. And of course, they were doing it all for publicity. These could be Mylar balloons. These could be other countries testing other technology. These could be our own countries testing technology. It just doesn't make any sense to me. And the other thing that has always confused me, and maybe you can help me out, is the people who are out, you know, out on a drive on some wilderness road, and then suddenly a bright light appears over their car and they're abducted or something like that. What's the point of the bright light? Is it? Because to me, the bright light exposes who you are instantly, and it gives everyone a chance to run away. I mean, if in our own technology, if we had a helicopter over a group of people or a drone and we want to abduct them, we're not going to shine a bright light on them. We're going to use infrared technology. I'm sure the aliens would have infrared technology, and we would use that. But no, every UFO has got to come up and shine the brightest lights possible just so you can have a chance to get out of your car and run away. Doesn't make any sense to me in the world. That's my quick commentary on UFOs. Hey, take a minute, like the channel. We do talk about current events, politics, all of those things. We will be talking about tech. You know I love tech, so I'll be working some of those stories in as we go along. So like, share, what else can you do? Like, share, follow, all of those things on whatever platform you're watching. And you can also go to jmcfarland.com. And please take a minute and join the JMac Members Club. As little as $5 a month will help me out, help me pay for all of the subscriptions that are required to bring this information to you. And if you come in at a higher level, then you get access to my books, my workshops, everything else. So I appreciate you listening. I really do. And I want to thank all of you who are out there and who are supporting the JMac podcast already. With that, my friends, thank you for joining me, and have a wonderful day.